What's up, guys? Shane here from FewGuy3D Printing, and today I'm going to hit you with a competition in order to get through this quarantine. So let's get talking about it. Welcome back, guys. So today we're talking about a new competition that we're going to host here on my channel and on the Discord. So a few days ago, someone on my Discord was talking about a sub $100 3D printer. Like, oh man, this would actually be really easy to make, yada, 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 and do things like that. And we all kind of got talking like, man, I'd like to take you up on that. Like, let's see if I could do it. And somebody else chimed in. So we thought this would be a really cool way for people to try their hand at designing a 3D printer. So that's what it's going to be about. A 3D printer is what I want people to design. Now, as I said, this came about from us talking, number one, but number two, this came about like super duper cheap 3D printers, which is the Easy3D X2. It is a $130 3D printer that boasts a 100 millimeter cube build volume, and it kind of looks like chunk. It really does. And the printing coming off it is meh. So the challenge is, can we build, or can you build, or can I build a better 3D printer under $130. Now, we did talk, and a lot of people are gonna shoot for a $100 goal. So if you can build a 3D printer for $100, that is all parts brand new, bought from any vendor. This is not including any shipping costs, because right now shipping is just ridiculous for certain things. And it's really not fair to count it now, because if you're watching this video in 6 months or a year or 2 years, you're not gonna have to worry about, hopefully, you're not gonna worry about, you know, $15 shipping on a $2 part. So we're not gonna worry about shipping right now. But again, the goal is larger than a 100 millimeter cube build volume. So 100 by 100 by 100, so we're straight on that. We wanna try and get it as close to $100 as possible. We'll have a little bit of bonus for if you get it under that and it does function and whatnot. But that is the goal. I think for me, I'm shooting for under 150. There's a few little niceties that I really don't want to give up. So again, but we're looking for 100 bucks. This must be custom made, custom 3D printed by you. You cannot take someone else's part and remix it. You can take inspiration from someone's part, but you cannot just grab it, throw it in, and that be that. We're trying to make everything as custom as possible by you. You can look at a printer and say, hey, that looks pretty cool. I'm gonna take this idea, that idea. I'm actually using three different printers for my inspiration and for what I'm looking for. And we did a little bit of talking, and we kind of thought out that the cheapest printer to make would be a crane style, we're calling, or a cantilever. So you have your bed mounted, you have a single Z coming up, and a single, or and your X coming across, nothing supporting on the far side. So it's kind of like an Ender 2, a Monoprice Mini, the new Prusa Mini. So similar to that style, we figure we could get that as cheap as we can from that. And these parts don't have to come from online either. I know some people are looking to source things locally from like a Home Depot or Lowe's, which is fantastic, but it has to function. And we're gonna go about this two different ways because of the timeline that we're gonna make on this. And you're gonna have 60 days, so 2 months from today, the day I'm posting, which is Monday, June 1st, we're gonna go all the way through August 1st on this competition, and that's when submissions need to be submitted. And the reason why I'm going 60 days is because there's gonna be two sets of people here that are gonna be working. One is gonna be someone who does not wanna buy the parts, but really wants to design a 3D printer and can do all of that in Fusion or whatever their flavor of 3D design is, but they need to show that it works, and they need to provide a listing of all the different parts, so like a Google Sheets document with all the parts and all the cost. And I'll work with a few other people. We'll try to vet everything, make sure everything is there and all the ducks are in a row, to say the least. But that's how we're gonna do. So that first one is, you just design it in 3D space, and you can show that it functions, doesn't crash, no things collide, and that the bed can move, X, Y, and Z all move properly. The second category is, we have the people who actually build this machine, and I am planning on actually building this machine. So I'm already starting to try and make sure, I did a lot of work over the past few days, just making sure, can we actually make this goal happen? Like, can you do a $100 or sub $100 3D printer completely DIY? And the answer is yes. If you sacrifice a few things here and there, you definitely can make it work. How well is it gonna print? I don't really know. We're going to find out when I finally build mine. But I definitely think this will be a super fun project. So here's what you need to do. You need to go ahead and pick out your modeling software of choice. Mine is Fusion 360. I recommend that other people use that as well. It's very easy to make things move in there, to design in your space, to create all different parts, import items into it. If you don't know how to use Fusion, there is a million different videos on YouTube in order to kind of get started with how to do that. But hey, you've got 60 days to do this, whether you're building or just designing, 60 days to get this done. So it is a good kind of goal for the summer and for this quarantine to give you a go on that. And if you want to participate, you'll need to hop on the Discord. So down below, there's a link to my Discord, and we have a channel specifically set up for the 3D printer competition, design competition. Feel free to share ideas in there and say, this works for me, this is not. I mean, I really now don't have any prizes for this. This is just something fun to do, and no one's expecting any prizes. I'm going to see if I can work something out in the next 2 months for everybody, but right now, this is just for fun. This is something to do. This is just a little project to say, yes, I built that. I did that. I designed that. I think it would be really fun, and that's what we're all kind of doing it for. It's just, hey, this is just something cool to make. Again, I will be building mine, and I will be doing probably a live stream build of it. I have most of the parts here, but I'm still sourcing everything on Ally. Okay, I have I've got some hot ends here. Okay, I'll find a hot end on Ally and call it for that one. You know, and the goal is to get it as close to or under $100 as possible. So when you're on the Discord, please interact with everyone, talk, hash out ideas. I'm having issues with figuring out how am I going to do an extruder. I've never designed an extruder mount before or a hot end mount before or any of this really. You know, I did some of the work for Megatron, but I remixed a ton of parts for this printer. And the goal is to be 100% unique. Doesn't matter what it looks like. It can just be square blocks or round circles. Doesn't matter. Just needs to function as a 3D printer. So this is the challenge. I hope you all will join in with this. Again, link down below for the Discord. I also have linked for like the rules sheet or suggestions is going to be in the top of that Discord channel. Just kind of keep everything in line. If anything changes, we'll talk about it in the channel and I'll update that Google sheet with what we're expecting. But I think it's going to be a really, really awesome project. Now I will say this, this is not meant to be your first 3D printer, especially if you're looking to build this. You're pretty much expected to have a 3D printer and to have a lot of like spare things kind of laying around. Or you don't have to have them, but we are not counting nuts and bolts, fasteners, per se, in this cost. Because if you're like me, you literally have drawers full or just stashes of M3, M4s, and M5s hanging around, T-nuts and lock nuts or Nylocks or just regular old nuts for all of these. You have a lot of this stuff laying around. That's why we're not going to count fasteners. It's also, I mean, depending on how many you buy, it can be upwards of like $20 just for fasteners. But again, this is not meant to be your first 3D printer. You've already had a 3D printer. You've dabbled with different things. You know what works, what doesn't for you. And you can kind of make a design off of that. Even if you're on your first 3D printer though, if you want to try and design one, if you want to try to build it, by all means, absolutely do that. But just realize there's certain things that we're taking liberties because there's a lot of us that are very experienced with just having 3D printers and working on them. I obviously have a lot of them here, but I've also built several machines on my own. And when you buy something, you never buy one, you buy 100 screws, so you have a lot laying around after the project is over. So that's why we're not gonna count those. So I think this is gonna be super fun. Please head over to Discord and chat with us about it. Again, it starts today, June 1st, is the day one of the design competition, and I will expect everyone to have their submissions submitted or their entries submitted by August 1st in the Discord. You can do a video, you can send me the F3D project file, you can post pictures of everything. We'll kind of hash that out there, but I would like everyone to have their completed project, either your printer is working or you have a digital design ready to go for this. So get started, get designing. Hope you guys enjoy this, and we'll see you guys real soon in another video. So until then, happy printing.